So the title does not deceive you at all. Will Bleach have a continuation? And this is a very important question that we should be asking ourselves because, and yes, if you have not read the chapter, which majority of you haven't at this point of the video, you can leave now because I will show end of the chapter spoilers in this video. So please, if you don't want to get spoiled, you may leave, but there is a conversation on the table that Bleach may continue. And we'll talk about that now once you've left. Have you left yet? You've been warned. Okay, cool. So, right. The chapter was a very interesting chapter and we'll talk about it within the review because there is a lot of context that I need in terms of translations that talk about a lot of Bleach lore and we need to discuss whether there's contradictions or whether there is going to be a fuck ton, and I mean a fuck ton, of headcanons in regards to old characters that have been long gone and dead. But we'll get onto that another point at some point in another day. This one is important because the way Bleach ends off, and as I said it in one of my videos, I can't remember which one I said, if it leaves off on a cliffhanger, that is an extremely good sign. And what did it do? It left off on an open-ended cliffhanger. There is, in fact, a fight in this chapter with a few captains in regards to one person and things that is happening within the Serrate. However, the way the chapter ends is, well, because of how broken Ichigo is, you see, Kubo was very smart on how to end this villain. And this villain obviously ends off with one of those, you know, gets dragged away type deals and Ichigo is left shocked. And then Ichika's kind of shocked and then Kazuhi's just vibing, which is kind of funny because Kazuhi is kind of the whole reason why things are kicking off right now. Kind of reminds me of the last chapter as well that he did. He's a bit of a walking problem, if I'm honest with you, and we love him for it. However, in this case, what the main focus is because of the context of the story, you can say, oh, okay, it's very open-ended. If Kubo wants to come back to it, he can come back to it. Cool, and that's fine. However, at the end of the chapter, it does say Bleach and then ... end in Japanese text, which is Owari, something like that. Owari. Yeah, I can't pronounce it. There you go. However, there is an editor note under Kazuhi that says there's two alternatives, and that is the story goes around or the story continues, which leaves up a lot of opening speculation because also on the page, and this is where it gets a bit weird. So when the official translations come out, this is of course going to be different. But in a nutshell, just for verbatim, just to give you an idea, it says in the middle of the page, the jail prison hell arc or something like that, which incites or insinuates that there is a beginning of a new arc in regards to this. I doubt it will classify itself as an arc in just one chapter alone. It could be a mini arc, but considering on how the chapter ended, it doesn't seem like this is the end for the person that was in the chapter, nor the lore that's going on, because Uketake made an appearance, Espada made an appearance. Don't spoil it if you read it in the comment section down below. Don't spoil it. But it seems like there's some information about Ichigo's Soul Reaper badge. There seems to be, again, Renji was very there's a lot to talk about, and I don't want to sidetrack here, but Renji seemed like very like not willing to fight an enemy, but he's fought him before, so you'd think why, but it seems like this enemy is way stronger than we've ever seen him before, so maybe there's some good lore too there. But yeah, but how do I say it? Shit, the way the end of the chapter happened, Kazuhi's walking away, it all walks towards a hell butterfly, his eyes brighten up, and that's the end of the chapter with it saying end and also the story continues. There's very two contradictory statements there, and also an arc that says jail prison arc or jail bright arc. I don't know, it's just something very hell arc-ish. So are we getting the hell arc? Honestly, it very much seems to conclude that is the case. It seems like we are in fact getting a new arc. Now, of course, the question is when are we getting this arc? And of course, that would be a question that we just don't know until we get more information whenever we get it. I know that in next week's Shonen Jump magazine, we will be having a Bleach news page. So will it be involved in that? Will they wait a couple weeks to talk about it? I don't know. Is this good? This takes place just after the last chapter that we got, so you still have 10 years time skip Ichigo and the gang, of course, with the captains, and we get to see more of what they're up to. So this is right after, and I think that this is fantastic. Not only has Kubo done fantastic with the marketing, we have the Thousand Year Blood War arc now, we have Can't Fear Your Own World, we have We Do Not Always Love You, we have the 10 year time skip where you can just smash anything in there if the anime wants to do some in-canon filler, or if Kubo wants to add stuff into that portion of the story, because why not, right? Whether that's Bankai training, whether that's how captains did the exams, or another threat with a royal family member. Who knows? There's some good playtime there, maybe even for movies, because, you know, why not? Shueisha loved their movies, right? Look at Kimetsu no Yaiba, for example, you know? I'm pretty sure Shueisha would love to replicate that. So, after we've got that, we have the 10-year time skip. And then after that, we have this chapter, which seems to be going into the Hell Arc, or Hell Palace, or whatever you want to call it. Maybe the devil. We might get the devil, right? And that's cool, because obviously I did a little Twitter space before this. People were talking about some very good questions about, you know, where do you go past the Soul King? Like, how strong can you get? And the question is, well, the Soul King never ruled Hell. That was like one of the realms that you cannot actually ever touch, because it's its own entity. Same with, like, well, it's not the same, but there's also ultimate dimensions to embrace. Bleach, and there's also pocket dimensions as well. So there's a lot to play with in terms of Bleach. I don't think it has exhausted anything in regards to its lore or world building, which is something that people were complaining about a lot, was its world building. But why is it important? I think Hell was a amazing choice to go for. Everybody loved, for the majority part, the Hell movie, but we know the complications with the Hell movie is that the studio didn't take Kubo's ideas into consideration. That's why we say, you know, the Hellverse is a part of a concept rather than an event. So it's canon in concept, which is why you will see someone like Clyde, for example, in his Stark video, use the chains of Hell as a term of power scaling, because it can be implied that, you know, the concept is correct rather than the event. So, you know, again, it doesn't really matter, because in this chapter, Ichigo cuts the chains anyway. So either way, these are really big deals. And again, I think this is amazing. I think this is smart. I hope that Nakano and Shueisha really take advantage of the Hell Arc. Kubo has improved yet again more of his art as per usual. Again, he's now fit and healthy, or healthier than he was when he was doing the serialization. So his art has improved drastically. And again, I'm glad that this didn't feel Boruto-esque. You know, the chapter for Boruto focused on the new generation a lot, while Bleach stayed to its roots. It stayed to Ichigo, stayed to the captain, stayed to the Soul Society, while giving us Kazuya and Ichigo in between. And if you can keep that dynamic, you've absolutely smashed it. But it does seem that Kazuya's OP. It does seem like that. And also, Ichigo is in the chapter. So it's really fun. Are we getting a Hell Arc? Again, I feel like it's happening. I just don't want to get people's hopes up, but it's like 99%. I mean, if you read the chapter, you will see. And it is insane, because the Hell Arc is amazing. Like, the Thousand Year Blood War Arc, mad. But now the Hell Arc. We're now fighting beings that we aren't even used to. So I'm fully gassed. I am fully, and I can't express it enough. I need to read this chapter in its official format, and I know you guys are going to get mad hype about it. So, is Bleach going to continue? From my standing, Bleach is continuing, guys. Burn the Witch, Bleach, Hellverse, let's fucking go! I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine, Debbie Nansen. As always, people, peace out.